Dear students of MA, this is Tahmina Madam. I hope you are doing well and keeping safe. We, all the teachers, are trying to keep you in touch with your studies in this current situation. This is why we are taking these online classes. Today, I am going to explain the poem, An Irish Airman Forces His Death, written by W.B. Yeats. Before going to discuss the poem, I would like to tell something about the poet. The poet W.B. Yeats was born in 1865 in Ireland and died in 1939. He was one of the foremost figures of the 20th century literature that is called modern literature. Now, I would like to recite the poem, An Irish Airman Forces His Death, by W.B. Yeats. I know that I shall meet my fate somewhere among the clouds above. Those that I fight, I do not hate. Those that I guard, I do not love. My country is kiltered and cross. My countrymen kiltered and poor. No likely end could bring them loss or leave them happier than before. Nor law, nor duty bade me fight, nor public men, nor cheering crowds, a lonely impulse of delight drove to this tumult in this cloud. I balanced all, brought all to mind. The years to come seemed waste of breath, a waste of breath the years behind, in balance with this life, this death. Okay, now let me discuss about the background of the poem. Or I would like to tell you that why the poet wrote this poem. Yeats wrote this poem as an elegy to Major Robert Gregory, the son of Lady Gregory. Lady Gregory was one of Yeats' best friends. She lived in Kiltartan. Robert joined the Royal Flying Corps in 1916. He earned a military cross for gallantry and devotion to duty. He died tragically at the age of 37 when an Italian pilot mistakenly shot him down. Now, I am going to explain the summary and analysis of the poem. This poem was written during the World War I. Yeats wrote the poem for an Irish airman named Robert Gregory, who was shot down over Italy. An Irish Airman Forces His Death is Yeats' attempt to get inside Gregory's head, so to speak, and describe Gregory's sense of life, certain death, and war. The speaker is in an unemotional state of mind and speaks in a cold, uncertain voice about his own life and death throughout the poem. His voice becomes warm when he is speaking of his neighbors in Kiltartan. When he speaks of the reasons as to why men go to war, his tone becomes cold again. When the speaker refers to the past and future of his life as a waste of breath, his tone becomes hateful. So, told from the perspective of an Irish fighter pilot in World War I, the poem is critical of both the war in general and specifically of British rule over Ireland. You know, Ireland was under control of British, which lasted until 1922. The speaker argues that the outcome of the war is ultimately meaningless for his small community in Western Ireland. So he feels no hatred towards his enemies, nor love for the British. The poem is composed of four quatrains in continuous 16-line stanza. Each quatrain has an A-B-A-B rhyme scheme. The poet uses the iambic tetrameter form of meter. Now I would like to tell you the conclusion of the poem. This poem is one of its most explicit statements about the First World War. The speaker of the poem does not hate or love his enemies or his allies. His country will neither be benefited nor harmed by any outcome of the war. He does not fight for political or moral motives, but because of his impulse of delight. His past life seems a waste, his future life seems that it would be a waste, and that his death will balance his life. Thank you, dear students.